Okay, hello everyone. Last time we had discussed about Horton's equation, basically to find out the infiltration rate. So this time we'll solve a few problems. We will solve a few problems from GATE exam. But before that, I wish to solve this particular problem. This is a very typical problem. The entire problem gives us a detailed idea about how can we solve more conceptual problems. So basically in this problem, this is not from the GATE exam, but once we understand such a problems, then it is very easy to solve the problems which are generally asked in the GATE exam. This is quite longer one because we are supposed to plot the graph and all, whereas in the GATE exam we don't observe plotting the graph and all. But still, I will try to use the Excel so that I can plot the graph very easily and effectively, so that we can save the time and we can cover the maximum points. Basically, this is a question in which, if I read the question, we'll have the more clear idea. The following observations were taken from double tube infiltrometer with inside ring diameter of 30 cm. That 30 cm is the inside tube diameter. Plot the infiltration capacity curve, and it means that for FT, for any time T, what would be the infiltration rate, and find the constant rate of infiltration at that is FC that the experimental field have toward the end. Also compute the average infiltration rate for the first 10 and first 30 minutes. So for the first 10 minutes, it means that if you consider this 10 minutes here, for 840 centimeter cube of the infiltration is there. So for this entire 840, how much is the average? So this is for first 10. Okay, so we can take the average of it, and that we want a rate. So in this way, we can find out the 30 minutes as well. So the procedure, what we will do is, we'll just open the Excel file in which same readings have been taken out. Actually, now it is visible. So here you can see the time and here the cumulative volume of water added as V in centimeter cube. Before that, actually area of the infiltrometer that we should calculate, and what is the formula to find out the area of the infiltrometer? Basically, area, that is A, is equal to, we can write as pi by 4 into d square. So pi by 4, the value we can put even directly. So from instead of taking from, I can take as it is 3.14 into divided by 4, pi by 4 into d square. So d is 30 here, 30 square. So, or 30 raised to 2 also I can write, and equal to how much it is that we need to calculate. So once we calculate, we'll have the more clear idea that what is the area of the infiltrometer. So what is the answer? So we get the answer equal to 306.86 centimeter cube. So this is the answer. So the area is most important thing, because we know the volume. If we divide this volume by area, we can find out the infiltration in terms of depth in centimeter, and divided by time we get the infiltration rate. So now coming to this particular Excel sheet, here I have prepared the different columns. In the first column, time is given and this cumulative volume is also given. So in the next step, what we will do is we want time in hours. Okay, so what is the time that is in hour that we will find out. Okay, so to do this, we are supposed to just divide by 60. As you know, we can convert. So we need to divide not this column, this column. So because this is for the minute, so divide by 60. So I can just drag this one and I will have the values of all. Okay, then what I will do, next step, this is the time increment delta t. So how can we find out? So in hours only, so the initial is 0 as it is, then second one we can find out this minus the previous one. So we'll get the same. Again in the next step also we'll do the this particular respective value minus the previous one we'll get, and then we can drag out so that we'll have the values for all. Okay, in the next step we are supposed to find out the incremental volume. So incremental volume, initially when the time is t is equal to 0, this value will be 0. Then in the next step the same way we'll do this 200 minus the previous one is 0. In the next step also the respective value is 470 minus the previous one is 200, so we'll get 270. So in this way we can just drag this entire up to the last and we'll have incremental volume of infiltration. And next step what we can do is we can find out the incremental infiltration. So incremental infiltration we can find out how, for which basically here what we have done is to find out the incremental infiltration. So basically infiltration is we will get how divided by area. So whatever the value we have got in terms of volume, that is in centimeter cube, so that we can convert into centimeter just divided by area. And how much is the area we have calculated over here? 706.86 centimeter cube. So whatever so I will just divide this value by 706.86. Okay, so and I will drag, so I will have the values of infiltration and that too in centimeter. And the last stage in which I will get the infiltration rate. So how can I get the infiltration rate? So whatever the value I got, the incremental one, so this one infiltration divided by which should I take, which time I should take, this one and this one. So I need to take in hours, but which one I should try take? I should take this one because this is incremental infiltration we are considering, so incremental time we should consider. And so we'll get the values. Actually it is just a minute. Yeah, so what I will do, okay, so what I will do, I will as for this it is when time is equal to 0, this value is will be incremental will also get 0, and 0 divided by 0 you know 0. So at the next step what we will do, simply this value divided by incremental time, so 0.03, and in the same way I will drag and so that I will have the idea of all these values. Okay, so now we have a clear cut idea about what is the infiltration rate. So in this way basically we can find out the infiltration rate. Now we can also plot the curve. So how can you plot the curve is basically if you go to the insert, I will just extend this one so that we can have more clear idea. Okay, so I'll go to the insert and in this there are the different options also by using which we can plot the graph, before which basically we should select the columns. Like you can plot time versus this infiltration rate. So time is in minutes and infiltration rate is in centimeter per hour. So I will take this is, and I'll select another one, and simply you can select. So we can check with anything, but I want time in on x-axis. Okay, so you can observe over here in this particular graph. Actually, I can just put the title and all, but for now I need not to spend time on this. So this is the time in minutes and this is infiltration rate. So you can observe when the time is equal to 0, the infiltration, or when time is equal to 2, the infiltration rate is too high. Okay, so for when time is equal to 2, the infiltration rate is 8.4. So, and then it decreases and it becomes finally 0.39, and 0.39 and 0.39, it is same, because at last the infiltration becomes constant and its final infiltration rate we can call it as FC. So the value of FC we have got, which is 0.39. So that is what is asked in the question. Next thing is, basically it is asked that what is the average rate of infiltration for the first 10 minutes. So we can plot this from graph also and from this particular table also. So from graph, how can we find out? So for the first 10 minutes, so we can take suppose anywhere here in between, and from which we will be able to find out. But instead of that, I will go with a simple thing. So for the first 10 minutes, okay, so by using this particular table, we can find out what is the average rate of infiltration for the first 10 minutes. So for the first minute, basically for the first 10 minutes, how much is the volume? So that is 840. So what I will do, 840 centimeter cube, that much of the infiltration was there in the first 10 minutes. So I will divide it by 10, so that I'll get the value 84 centimeter cube per minute. I can convert into centimeter cube per hour. How? By multiplying it by 60. So if I multiply 84 by 60, then I'll get the value 5040. Sorry, I have written here it is 84. Okay, so 5040, and that value I have got in centimeter cube per hour. If we divide this quantity by area of infiltrometer, which is 706.86, so I'll get the value equal to 7.13. so this 7.13 is in centimeter per hour. In the same way, we can find out for first 30 minutes also. So for the first 30 minutes, suppose in centimeter cube per hour, we can write as how much it is for first 30 minutes. So it is 1840. So 1840, and if we need to convert centimeter cube per minute, so we need to divide this 1840 by 30. So I'll get the quantity in minute, 61.33. Okay, and to get the value in meter centimeter cube per hour, I need to multiply it by 60. So 3680 is centimeter cube per hour, and if I just divide it by area, so the area of infiltrometer is 706.86, then I'll get the answer as a 5.21. so 5.21 is the average rate of infiltration for the first 30 minutes. So you can observe over here, so 30 minutes is around here. Okay, and so for first 30 minutes, you can see the rate which we have got. So that is around 5.21. okay, so 5.21, you can take this one. So from the graph also we can find out, or even from this table also we can find out. Okay, so this is all about how can we find out the infiltration capacity, which is 0.39. how can we find out the average rate of infiltration for the first 10 minutes, for the first 20 minutes, 30 minutes, we can find out. And now we'll solve one simple problem which was asked in the GATE exam. So it was It was asked in the GATE 2017. So the problem is here, the infiltration capacity of soil follows the Horton's exponential model, F is equal to C1 plus C2 e raised to minus KT. During an experiment, the initial infiltration capacity was observed to be 200 mm per hour. After a long time, the infiltration capacity. So from here, what kind of idea we can get? Like initial infiltration capacity, it means F naught is equal to 200 mm per hour. After a long time, the infiltration capacity, that is FC, was reduced to 25 mm per hour. If the infiltration capacity after 1 hour, means for any time t is equal to 1 hour, was 90 mm per hour is value of FT. The value of decay rate constant K is how much? So that is what we are supposed to find out. So in this case, basically what we can do is, we can solve this particular equation. How? I will just take this particular question to the board, and from the board it is very easy to solve this particular question. So this is the particular question, and we can solve here. So I'll take the pencil. First and the most important thing is that what is given in this particular, what I will do, it is too small actually, so I will first erase this part. And I will zoom it. I will take up to the 100%. In the last session, we have solved this particular equation, and the same equation we are supposed to use. So what is the equation? Ft is equal to Fc plus F naught minus Fc into e raised to minus kt. So from whatever the equation is given, from that equation what we can understand. So I will just take the text here. Okay, so here I will write what is F naught, what is Fc, and then we'll compare with the same equation. So what is F naught? So from this question we can understand that F naught is equal to 200 mm per hour. So I will write here, I will take a different color so that we can differentiate the answer. So I'll write here, F naught is equal to 200 mm per hour, 200 mm per hour. Basically this we should convert to the centimeter per hour. So I will mention here 20 centimeter per hour, because in the equation this is in centimeter per hour, that's why we are converting. Then what is this 25 mm per hour? This 25 mm per hour is the final infiltration rate, that we can mention as Fc. So Fc is equal to 25. So this 25 is mm, so I will write directly 2.5 centimeter per hour, because we want all the quantities in centimeter only. Then I'll just erase this part. Then the next we are supposed to mention what is this 90 mm per hour. So basically 90 mm per hour, it means that it is Ft. So for any instant time t, this Ft is equal to 90, means 9 centimeter per hour. So for which time, or how much is the time? T is equal to 1 hour. Okay, so now we have all the values, and but still we'll write the Horton's equation first so that we can compare it. So what is the Horton's equation? So that is what actually we had discussed in the last session. So Ft is equal to Ft is equal to Fc plus FC plus F naught, F naught minus FC, F naught minus FC into e raised to minus kt, e raised to minus kt. So now we know all the values except k. So I will put the value FC, we know how much it is. FT we know. So this is FT. So FT is equal to 9 cm per hour. Then the next one is FC. This is not the F naught, this is FC. So F naught is here. So FC is 2.5. F naught is equal to 200. Again FC is equal to 2.5 into e raised to minus k only, because t is equal to 1. So 9 minus, okay. So in this equation basically this is not the 200, it should be 20 only. So I will just erase 1 and yes, now it is correct. So we'll process for the next part. So 9 minus 2.5, so equal to 6.5 I can mention. So 6.5 is equal to this 20 minus 2.5, so that is also 17.5 into e raised to minus k. So I'll get answer is e is equal to minus k is equal to this 6.5 divided by 17.5. So you will get 0.3714. And if you divide, if you take a ln from both the sides, so you will get minus k is equal to minus, if you take a ln from both the sides, you will get minus k is equal to minus 0.99. So it means that k is equal to 0.99. So this is the final answer of what is asked. So this is the final answer, k is equal to 0.99, and this was the question which was asked in the GATE exam. So this is all about how we can find out the different terms from the infiltration by using Horton's equation. The next problem is this one, which was asked in GATE 2018, that was in set 2. So the problem is the infiltration rate F in a basin under ponding condition is given by F is equal to 30 plus 10 into e raised to minus 2t, where F is in mm per hour and time t is in hour. Total depth of infiltration in mm during the last 20 minutes of a storm of 30 minute duration is how much? So here I will give you one hint, and you are supposed to solve this particular problem. So it is given that during it is asked that total depth of the infiltration during the last 20 minutes of a storm of 30 minutes. It means that from 10 minutes up to the 30 minutes, how much is the total depth of the infiltration? So that is what is asked. But what we have just this equation. So by using this particular equation, and the condition is given over here, you can solve this particular equation and find out the answer.